I'd do without your smart mouth, drawing me in and you kicking me out. You've got my head spinning, no kidding, I can't.
Belong to one another. They begin to unite together in their community is in a way of life that all should honour. It must not be taken carelessly, lightly or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly and after serious thoughts. This is the way of life created and hallowed by God. That Kevin and Chelsea are now to begin. They will give each other their consent to the other. They will join hands and exchange solemn vows. And in token of this, they will give each other and receive a ring. Therefore, on this their wedding day, we pray with them that, strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. But first, I am required to ask anyone present who knows the reason why they should not marry to declare it now. The vows you two are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you two know of any reasons why you may not openly marry, you must declare it now. Right, that's it. I don't know if you were worried about that. There's a big sigh from the front here. The response to the next two questions is, I will. Kevin, will you take Chelsea to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Chelsea, will you take Kevin to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
She said, I will.
Congregation, this is where you respond, and the answer to this question hopefully is we will. Congregation, will you, the families and friends of Kevin and Chelsea, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
That was about 18%. I won't say you're saying that. Mostly outside, didn't I? Yes. God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessing upon Kevin and Chelsea, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I would like you two to please be seated for a second. And I believe we have Terry Jane, who is going to do the Bible reading for us.
Okay.
That's it.
My command is this: love each other as I loved you. Greater love has known one than this, that he laid down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. I learned from my father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit. Fruit that will last. Then the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. This is my command, love each other.
You can relax now as well. Now, we've already said it earlier on, but I remember many years ago when I got married, I was standing at the front. And I was worried about not the two words, I will. Now, why do you think would I worried about that? Well, as you might imagine so far, I'm very good at mixing my words up. And I was worried I was going to say, will I? Now, it's a case of two very small words, but the wrong way round. You might just get a clip down the back of the ear. I'm looking at you at the moment. Yeah, no, you're looking worried about that. But it is a case of communication in marriage is really important. But it's not necessarily the words you say, it's what you say. And hopefully my wife, as we've been together now 20, oh,
5 years, I mean, that's going to be expensive this year, isn't it?
25 years. It's a case of saying to her, I will. Well, like I said, will I? She would have known my heart. But what I want to tell you guys, in your marriage, it is about communication. It's communication between each other. It's believing the best of one another. It's knowing what they are really about. Not necessarily the words sometimes we say, but knowing who we are really inside. So there's times in life where we have the odd argument in our marriage. Not that we do that often, obviously. But when we do have an argument, follow my grandmother's advice, which is never go to sleep on an argument. Now, Kevin, that doesn't mean you stay awake for 3 months just to prove a point. But it's believing the best. It is saying sorry to one another. It's saying, I believe the best in you. I know the best in you. I know that's what you're wanting. Now, it's a case of within a marriage, you're making promises. You're making them before each other. Very, very important. You're making them in front of these people here. And they are standing with you. And they have said, 87 said, that they will be with you and be supporting there for you. Use them as family and friends to be there in your marriage, to give you advice. Sometimes you might not want to take it. And looking around is a pure assurance you won't take it from. But on the whole, they're here to support you and be with you as it's going on. You're going to be making words and saying things to each other. You're going to be signing documents, legal documents. But it's a case of those documents you just put to one side. But it is about the promises that you're having to each other, to these people, and before God. And God likes being involved in all our marriages and all our lives. He likes being involved in these major decisions of our lives. He doesn't care about the wallpaper. He doesn't care when we buy a new set of saucepans. He doesn't care about that, but he wants to be involved with the two of you together. And we quite often worry about the word prayer. We think, I can never say the right words. Prayer is just a sentence. It's a communication. You can start off with dear God if you want to, if you don't need to. You can finish with amen at the end if you don't need to. But it's about those times when things are not necessarily going your way or when they are going your way. It's saying, God, I know you can be involved in our marriage. And talking to him as you would, maybe not all your friends, but to some of your friends. All right. It's about that is what prayer is about. It's about communicating with God. And I would like to finish off with a poem that I think is very apt to Kevin. It's called To Keep Your Marriage Ringing. This is for both of you, but I think you'll appreciate this. To keep your marriage ringing with love in the loving cup. Whenever you're wrong, admit it. Whenever you're right, shut up. Alright. I'm now going to invite the pair of you to come back forward, and the best man and father of brothers. Now this is the point which over centuries we've called who gets this woman. Now I don't think people own each other and what have you, but it's almost a case of who gets this woman to join the families together. And that's what we discussed yesterday or whenever we had the rehearsal, and that's what we've got going on. So who gets this woman to be joining the families together? If I could ask you to face each other and hold right hand to right hand now, I'd like you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and his people. Kevin, please repeat after me. I, Kevin, take you, Chelsea.
I, Kevin, take you, Chelsea.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for
richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy law, in the presence of God, I make this vow. You might release hands again. You've now been holding their hands and making a declaration. Now you're going to be holding the same hands again, but now you're going to take right hand to right hand. and you're going to be making a vow looking into his eyes. I shall see, take you, Kevin.
I shall see, take you, Kevin.
To be my husband.
Be my husband.
To have and to hold.
Have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God,
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
Second, who has the rings? One. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be as Kevin Chelsea, a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they make this day, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Kevin, please repeat after me. Chelsea, I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honor you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
It's... Just please repeat after me. Kevin, I give you this ring.
Kevin, give me this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In the presence of God and before this congregation, Kevin and Chelsea have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. We give them a round of applause. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may be pleasing to him in body, mind, and soul, living together in faith and love, and may receive the blessing of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Rugby fans might know what to do. In number 31 in the book, in 31 Jerusalem.
Thank you.
have a moment of quiet as we pray for the newly married couples. Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of love, we thank you and praise you for bringing Kevin and Chelsea to this day. And we pray for them that they may, in their marriage, be life-giving and lifelong, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace, and they may bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. May they discern in your word order and purpose for their lives, and may the power of your Holy Spirit lead them in truth and defend them in adversity. Amen. Now let's see if we know the Lord's Prayer. As we say that, if those who know that will join in with me, you pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love. Defend us, God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Be with you and remain with you in your marriage now and always. Amen.
And I can't sweep you off of me. Will your mouth still remember the taste of my heart? Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? And darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23. I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. Maybe just the touch of a hand. Me, I fall in love with you.
Hello everyone, thank you for coming. I just want to say thank you very much to my lovely wife, wherever she is. She looks beautiful. There we go. Let's stand up.
Look, I just want to say, right, that woman's made me the happiest man for the past 3 years.
Right? Yeah. That was me!
Right? And I'm so glad that I married her today. She's made me the happiest man in it. Right? And you know I'm not. I'm a comical person because there's kids. But there we go. I just want to say thank you very much. And have a good drink.
And I would like to say, everyone, thank you very much for coming. Kevin, where am I? He's took a weight off my back.
Is it my turn? Brilliant. That's that wind for us. Okay, so you want to go first? Now? Right.
I'm going first now. I've been going to do it. Right. I want to go back to a little while when I first met Dodd. It's a story that's never ever gone away.
Everyone sit down.
And yeah, I got very drunk, what you do, with Dodd. And he went to bed with Gaz, I have to say, which is a bit odd. And then mine.
And I was a lot younger than Dodd then, and I felt very ill. And the only place I could be sick was all over Dodd and his bed. So like they say, shit don't stick, but sick does. And he's stuck around ever since with me and him, brilliant guys. And other than that, I'll say well done Chelsea, well done Dodd, great couple, great night, great day. Thank you very much.
Just so I don't even know him. I don't even like him. And he's pulled me up here to be his best man. Silly son. So what I've done is write a poem. Because I like poems. So here we go. Should we do it to a timer?
We've got a timer.
We have a timer. Hopefully.
It's warm as well.
I think he might smash me. So, you ready? Dodd, you are round. You have turned Chelsea's life upside down. Not because of your love and desire, but because of your gorgeous friends. She's acquired. Dodd, you are round. Reckon best. Finish. I'm going to finish. Sorry, I'm gonna finish. I'm finishing. Get another one for him. Anyway.
Come on, which next one?
Reckon best looking fat man in town. I've known you for years and I've got a lot to say, but best not down here. I'll save for another day. I've got all the gossip. Dodd, you are round. You just keep on going, never a frown. Dodd and Chelsea, you guys look divine. Now I'm going to stop talking, it's drinking time. Yeah.
At the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment in each other's face, so much in love, you're alone in this place, like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was a number one, she told me so. And she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday. But it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. How could that beautiful woman with you be the same freckle-faced girl that I knew, the one that I read all those fairy tales to, and tucked into bed all those nights? And I knew the moment I saw you with her, it was only a matter of time. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. Someday you might know what I'm going through, when a miracle smiles up at you. But I loved her first.